she gave me like, you have to. So I said, okay, fine, I will. So that's why you love him. So it wasn't me. It was her fault. That first picture is me the weekend before my wedding. And I'm really nervous. It's really disappointing to me that my wedding dress pictures look like that. And being a wedding photographer for my full-time job, I knew better. I knew that the camera added 10 pounds, but so did cupcakes. You know what I mean? So I don't really know why it didn't work out before, but it's a good reminder every time I see my wedding pictures of what not to go back to. I have cystic fibrosis. For those of you that don't know what that is, it's a lung disease. It's genetic. I was born with it. I am going to cry. Okay, I'm going to try not to. All my life, I've heard that the life expectancy is 30 years old. If you guys Google it and you look up cystic fibrosis, typically it's about 30. A lot of times people get real sick and they live in the hospital and they don't really go past their teenage years. For whatever reason in my head, I just always thought 30 was it. I guess I just never could picture myself being 40. I don't know if that makes any sense. I know that sounds a little, you know, sadistic or something, but I was at peace with it. It was just kind of like back in the back of my head, like I'll never reach over 30. Ended up having my son at 28, and he's awesome and beautiful and amazing, and I'm 33. And so it got to the point where I was like, you know, 20-something pounds overweight, and my lung function was down. I've always been a swimmer. My mom put me in swimming, and she made sure that I was athletic, and she made sure that I did all that stuff to keep my lungs strong. But whenever I was 18, I got in a car accident, and I shattered my right foot and my ankle and every bone. And so I had screws and pins in my foot. And I guess after that, I just let the excuses happen. I tried to swim every once in a while, but it just hurt. And you guys could tell if you looked closely, but my right leg is really skinny and my left leg is normal. So that was always an excuse for me too. I couldn't jump, I couldn't run, I couldn't do any of those things. And so slowly my lung function started to decrease, and I went to the doctor multiple times a year, and I was constantly sick, always on medication and stuff. So I guess once I had my son, you know, it really hit me that like, I'm the one in control of whether I go past 30. You know, it's up to me. It's not up to the magazines. It's not up to the doctors. It's not up to the internet telling me that I'm not going to go past 30. So I kind of got mad at it. I got really mad at it, actually. I decided that I was going to kick CF in the teeth because I want to dance with my son at his wedding. So again, I got mad and I was like, watch me. And so I would go in at 4:30 in the morning and I would work out in the middle of their workout so that they would see me. Because I was so mad, you know. And then I started incorporating P90X moves into their dry land workouts, and then they really were hating me. But I finished P90X and I lost 14 pounds. And today, where I stand today, my lung function is better than it was when I was 18 and I was a swimmer 6 hours a day. And then in October, the screws in my ankle started backing out. My foot randomly swelled up like a sausage and it was disgusting. It was really painful. So I went to the doctor and the orthopedic surgeon told me that the screws were backing out and I have to go back in and do surgery again. Yay. And so went back in, I got surgery again, got everything removed, which is great, actually, because I went from, I can only have range of motion in my foot to 85 degrees, now I'm at 95 degrees, so it's been a blessing, actually, but I'm still in the road to recovery. I know you guys can tell I have my brace on. I live in the modifier, so any workout that doesn't have a modifier I don't do it, you know? Either that or I modify it myself. So P90X has been my friend, Turbo Fire's been my friend, and now T25 is my friend. But I'm healthy, and I do want to say that because of Shakeology, I used to take handfuls of pills to digest my food. That's part of cystic fibrosis, is that that your body creates too much mucus and it plugs the holes to be able to actually, for your pancreas to create enzymes. So you have to eat enzymes before you actually eat or you can't digest your food. I'm down to one every meal because of Shakeology. My CF doctor is so excited about what Shakeology has done for me that she's actually pushing Shakeology to go through a clinical CF trial so that other CF patients can have it too. Anyway, mine is more of a why story, I guess you could say, but my why is so that I can dance with my son at his wedding. Every single day I get up and I have the same doubts and fears and I can't do this that everybody does, but I feel like I just have to get mad at myself and I have to get mad at the CF every single day. And I have to remind myself that if I don't do this, then my lung function will decrease and then I'm the one making my chances less to grow old with him. And really, I know that my story is a little dramatic and that not everybody has this story, but I'm hoping that somehow if I tell you this story, that you'll know that there is no obstacle too big to get where you want to get, whether it's in your workouts or in your business. Get pissed at the obstacles, and I promise you that that's going to change your perspective. And I just truly believe that you can do anything, anything at all, and that God's going to bless that, and he's going to blow that up for you just like he has for me. And now I'm possibly going to be able to help other CF patients just because of my story, and that makes me so happy. So thanks for having me.